The second circuit that we're going to do for this project involves using two push buttons to power the LED light. In this circuit, we're going to be putting those push buttons in series. That means one right after the other. A good example of something being in series would be doing your laundry. You first have to put it into the washing machine to clean it, and then you take your clothes out of the washing machine and put it into the dryer to dry them. You have to do one after the other. You can't put them in both machines at the same time and both wash them and dry them. And that, of course, will provide an interesting behavior when we connect the circuit. So the step one, and I'm put one in quotations because it's not really the first step. We're starting with the last circuit we had, but I'm going to start the step numbers over for this circuit. So go ahead and remove the resistor from the circuit and just set it aside. We'll be adding it again later into our circuit. Go ahead and look through your jumper wires to find a jumper that will go between the two push buttons. I'm just going to use one of the small red ones here. I'm going to attach one end of it to a pin on one of the push buttons, and the other end of this jumper wire is going to be attached to one of the pins on the other push button. So since one of the ends on the jumper wire is in row 15 and one of the pins of the push button is in row 15, they are both connected to each other. So the next step of this is going to be to find another push button and place that on the breadboard, again with the legs straddling the little valley there in the center like a chip would do. And you want to make sure that you line up one of the pins with the other side of that red jumper cable. For this next step, go ahead and take that resistor that you set aside, and we're going to go ahead and reconnect it into the circuit. We're going to attach one side to the positive rail and the other side to one of the pins on the push button. When you have done that, you have the basic circuit laid out on the breadboard for this second circuit. Let's go ahead and trace the flow of positive charge to make sure we understand what this circuit is doing before we add power and test it out. So power is going to flow from the red cable to the resistor using this positive rail. It's going to go across the resistor. And then since the other side of the resistor and one of the pins of the top push button are on the same row, row 11, the top left pin of the push button is going to be powered. When we push down on the push button, it will allow the current to flow through the push button to the bottom left pin, which is in row 13. You'll see that one side of the red jumper wire is also in row 13, and so that's going to allow the current to flow through the red jumper to row 15, which is also in the same row as the top left pin of the bottom push button. When that push button is pushed, it will allow current to flow through the second push button to the bottom left pin on row 17, which is also connected to the long leg of our green LED. And so that's going to allow the current to flow through the longer leg, through the LED, and down through the shorter leg, where it returns to the ground through the ground cable and the ground rail. Now, before we get to it, I want you to think on what would happen if neither of the push buttons are pushed, right? They're both open. Think about what would happen if only the top push button is pushed. Think about what would happen if only the bottom push button is pushed. Think about what would happen if both of them are pushed. And see if you can figure out what behavior we're going to see based on the layout of the circuit. So let's go ahead and attach the USB cable to our Arduino, and that's going to provide power to the Arduino. The Arduino is going to provide power to our red and black cable, and that's going to provide power to our circuit. So let's go ahead and test this circuit and see what it does. I'm going to go ahead and press one button at a time, and you'll notice that the LED light is not lighting up. However, when I push down both buttons, the LED button lights up. This is because it's in series, and so if either of the push buttons is off or unpushed, it breaks the circuit and it doesn't allow anything to flow through it. And so both need to be pushed to be able to turn on the LED light. This is a different behavior than what we'll see in the next circuit when we look at what would happen if we wired these two buttons up in parallel. However, before we get to modifying this circuit to put the push buttons in parallel, let's go ahead and remove the USB cable so that we remove power from our circuit, and when we work on it, it's de-energized.